now on Coast TV News.
Proposed wind farms off the coast of Ocean City being discussed in town as we speak. Why officials aren't too optimistic.
Appealing a controversial development, why Oak Orchard locals are fighting back against developers on this one.
A stunning stretch of weather on the way to the coast. I'll have your beach forecast coming up in just a few moments.
From above, the Mayer Institute in Lewis asking to relocate. Why the Institute argues the move will help clean up the historic site and clean up that mess.
This is Coast TV News at 5.
Looking out on the horizon could contain wind farms in Ocean City. Good evening. I'm Madeline Overturf.
And I'm Charlie Sakaitis. Welcome to our News at 5. We begin tonight with proposed offshore wind turbines causing more concern.
A federal agency is looking to hear from the public on those proposed offshore wind turbines in the waters off of Ocean City. Coast TV News reporter Charles Reiner, he joins us live there in Ocean City. Charles, it's happening right now.
Maddie, right behind me here at Ocean City Elementary School, the Bureau of Ocean Energy Management, or BOEM, is discussing the possibility of these turbines with the public. In fact, if we take a step to my right here and take a look here, you can see this is the line of people waiting to get in to discuss these turbines tonight. Now, according to the agency, these turbines would be enough to power over 700,000 homes, not only here in Ocean City, but across Delmarva. According to the town, these turbines would be massive, over 9 stories tall. But here in Ocean City, the town isn't so sure about the additions to its horizon.
That's so close to Ocean City, it will destroy the horizon off the town of Ocean City, and it'll make the sunrise, which is a pristine sunrise in Ocean City, have a backdrop of Star Wars.
If you can't make the meeting tonight, you are in luck, because there is one more meeting discussing this topic this coming Thursday at Indian River High School in Dagsboro. I'm Charles Reiner, live in Ocean City, Coast TV News.
And this brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know what your thoughts are towards wind farms. Let's take a look at the early results.
Take a look at your screen. So far, a majority are saying positive, but a slight majority, 42%, say negative. Only 12% say they're neutral about wind turbines. It's worth noting that a lot of people say they are good for the environment, job creation, and some say you're not going to see them offshore. So it's really a divisive topic.
And if you want to get involved in this divisive topic, if you want your vote counted in our poll, you can go to CoastTVNews.com or use the Coast TV mobile app. Breaking news this afternoon, Tom Emmer of Minnesota, who was nominated by House Republicans
for Speaker of the House, he has dropped out of that race in the fifth and final round of voting earlier today. Emmer defeated Mike Johnson of Louisiana. Now, it's increasingly unclear whether any Republican can get the 217 votes needed to win the gavel from bitterly divided conference. The House remains effectively frozen, a dire situation as Congress faces a funding deadline in November. The Carl M. Freeman companies have once again set their sights on land for developing 9 acres in Fenwick Island. This comes about 2 years after a previous hotel for the same piece of land was rejected. From our Coast Copter, you can see the 9-acre parcel of land that's up for discussion. It's located off Route 54 and Bennett Road. The company says it wants to rezone the land and build 23 units. It says this better aligns with the surrounding area, both in type and density. CEO Michelle Freeman says, quote, "We remain committed to developing the property in a manner that is sensitive to the surrounding area and environment," end quote. Freeman says the company will add buffers and road improvements to address all of the neighbors' concerns.
The Mayer Institute in Lewis is looking to relocate to the Green Hill Light Historic Site, where a lighthouse used to be at the end of Pilot Town Road. With hundreds of creatures from sea turtles to seal pups rescued each year, the nonprofit has well outgrown its small space. It is looking to relocate to the historic site to be able to expand within educational facility and room to care for even more animals, meanwhile revitalizing a forgotten piece of maritime history.
Fortunately, it was not maintained. It has fallen into complete ruin. It's completely collapsed at this point. There are some remnants, though, of where the light stood and the little oil house where the oil was stored. So we see that as potential to bring that back to life.
The Mayer Institute will present these plans to the mayor and city council at their workshop on Friday, October 27th at 10 a.m.
Thursday, October 26, Sussex County officials are holding a conference to talk about workforce housing. Officials say they will discuss accessory dwelling units like tiny homes and garage apartments and look at where ADUs have worked in the past. Research one family and zoning law changes. They're also going to talk about the economic impact of home building across the state. This is from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. on the 26th. You can attend in person at Del Tech in Georgetown or virtually.
The proposed housing development of Stillwater Harbor off of River Road and Oak Orchard is back up for debate. The 57-acre, 120-home development was originally denied by the Sussex County Planning Commission back in June, but developers, their attorney, made an appeal about the project in court today. People who live in Oak Orchard are worried that the project is a safety hazard.
Well, the more people, the harder it is. And you need to have a way to get out. And that, where that development is, it becomes an island pretty fast, but there's no way in or out off of River Road. It kind of floods it between that development. It kind of floods and isolates that area. So that's a risk there.
The attorney for the developer says that the project will actually contain flooding in the area and will help address the high demand for housing in Sussex County. No word yet on when Sussex County Council will make a decision on Stillwater Harbor's appeal.
As we take a live look right now into Ocean City from our 45th Street Tap House camera there, courtesy of Hershey Exteriors, a beautiful day on Delmarva. Honestly, a beautiful week. Let's check in with our meteorologist, Alex Seymour, who's in for Paul Williams tonight. Alex, you are bringing good news.
Yeah, bringing some fantastic news, especially if you like the warm weather. It's a little bit cool today, but it's only going to go up from there. We're going to be talking about temps possibly closing in on 80 degrees by the time we head into the weekend. Right now, as I take a live look out on our Boardwalk Plaza Hotel camera in Rehoboth Beach, a pretty quiet evening on the boardwalk in Rehoboth Beach. Temps sitting right around 63 degrees. We're in the 60s to close to 70 degrees all across Delmarva this evening. A beautiful evening. Spend a little bit of time outdoors. It will get cool, though, again overnight down into the upper 40s again. Winds rather light. Sky's completely clear. Get outside and enjoy this dog walking forecast for this evening. Slowly falling into the 50s and then overnight back down into the 40s. But really, this is the last chilly night tomorrow. It's going to be looking gorgeous. Sunshine temps in the upper 60s on Astag Island. Pretty similar conditions in Ocean City and Fenwick Island. Actually climbing up to near 70 degrees in both those locations. And the low 70s in both Lewis and Rehoboth Beach.
Alex, thank you. Well, as we continue to lose sunlight, trees are beginning to lose their leaves. But get this, you don't really need to break out the rake. That actually creates unnecessary work. There's a much more efficient way to rake in the benefits Mother Nature has to offer.
Suck them up with a mower, recycle them, chop them up into small pieces, returns valuable nutrients back into the soil. In addition, it gives it more organic matter.
Leaves can also keep weed seedlings from germinating in the spring and help keep the soil moist in drier months.
As two more hostages are released from Hamas control, Israeli-American Galia Mizrahi awaits the fate of her four kidnapped family members and attends the funeral for two of her cousins who were murdered in the Hamas terror attack. She spoke exclusively with NBC's Alice Barr about the excruciating experience that, as the healthcare system in Gaza is on the verge of collapse. President Biden saying today that aid is not reaching those who desperately need it quickly enough.
New images of two released hostages show the elderly Israeli women being transferred from Hamas custody to Israeli forces. 85-year-old Yocheved Lifshitz says she was treated relatively well in captivity after going through hell.
My mom is telling the horrific stories. She's saying that many, many people, a swarm of people, came through the fence.
Their appearance like a mirage for the more than 200 families still waiting for word of their loved ones kidnapped by Hamas.
They're going to push our buttons because they know how precious all these lives are and how desperately we want them all back.
American Ghalia Mizrahi has four family members among the hostages. Two more were murdered in the October 7th terror attacks. She traveled from Los Angeles to Israel and attended the funerals, complete with a military procession.
There was something very shocking just seeing it in front of your eyes.
I wonder if you feel of two worlds or how this has maybe reshaped some of your views and your feelings.
As terrible as it is to be here right now and how as exhausting and sad, there are also moments of such beauty and how people have gotten together.
Amid urgent hostage negotiations, Secretary of State Antony Blinken at the UN Security Council calling for the first time for a pause in Israel's aerial bombardment of the Gaza Strip to get hostages and Palestinian civilians to safety and let humanitarian aid in.
Humanitarian pauses must be considered for these purposes.
President Biden saying today food, water, and medicine are not getting into Gaza quickly enough amid desperate shortages of supplies and a medical system on the brink of collapse. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.
And the spokesman for the National Security Council today clarified what Secretary Blinken called for there, a humanitarian pause, noting that is not the same thing as calling for a full ceasefire, which the Biden administration believes would, right now, only benefit Hamas. Coming up, a lot of money in interest. How many billions Americans reportedly shelled out in credit card interest last year?
A beautiful stretch of late October weather on the way to the coast. I'll have your forecast for all those outdoor fall activities coming up in just a few minutes.
But first, a community fair coming to the State Service Center in Georgetown. What the Department of Health and Social Services wants to provide Delawareans. That story is up next.
When you're close to the land and the sea, you can taste the goodness. The historic Lewis Farmers Market brings farms closer to tables. Meet the growers, talk to the people that milk the cows, and pick the perfect peaches. Organically grown fruits and vegetables, sustainable meats and eggs, A2 dairy products, artisan breads, and fresh local seafood.
The historic Lewis Farmers Market is now in the Lewis Elementary School parking lot on Savannah Road every Saturday from 9 to noon.
I'm Delaware Insurance Commissioner Trinidad Navarro. Many people have questions about Medicare and don't know where to start. The good news is there's a way to get answers. Delaware Medicare Assistance Bureau is a public service of the Delaware Insurance Department and helps people with Medicare deal with a complex and confusing health insurance system. DMAB offers free, local, one-on-one counseling and assistance to people with Medicare and their families. Call Delaware Medicare Assistance Bureau at 302-674-7364 today.
When it comes to building your new home, don't settle for anything less than the best. Bay to Beach Builders is your trusted source for experience, quality, and design. Our team of experts work with you from start to finish to create your dream home. Expect an elevated customer experience with home visualizers, virtual home tours, and technology-inspired selections in our design studios. Visit one of our two convenient locations in Greenwood and Ocean View, or visit baytobeachbuilders.com. Your new home journey is a click away.
Middays with me, April Brilliant. It's a feel-good show on your radio.
April is the easiest way to get through your workday.
She can play your favorite song.
She can help you find your furry friend.
The easiest way to get through your workday is with April.
She really makes you feel special.
Hey friends, hang out with me weekdays here on Coast Country 103.9 and 106.3 each day from 10 to 3.
This is Coast TV News at 5.
Delaware Health and Social Services is coming to Sussex County to host a community resource fair. Representatives from the department will discuss emergency services assistance, a children's disability program, and more. There we go. It's on October 27th, that's Friday, from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. at the Adams State Service Center, that's in Georgetown.
Seaford parents, if you want to enroll your kids in basketball, and who doesn't? You've got four more days left to do it. It's a co-ed youth basketball league for kids from 6 to 13 years old. Now, the practices, those begin in December, and games, they begin in January. All games are going to be played at the Seaford Middle School. Online registration closes at 4 p.m. on Friday. That's October 27th. It is $45 per player to register.
The Consumer Financial Protection Bureau says Americans paid $105 billion in credit card interest alone last year. That staggering figure comes from the biennial credit card report. Now listen to this. The report says Americans shelled out $25 billion in fees last year as borrowing costs hit record highs. The Bureau warns that nearly a tenth of credit card users end up in persistent debt. Now, persistent debt is when they are charged more in interest and fees than they pay towards principal.
Well, some much warmer temps are on the way to the coast this week, heading into the week, and I'll let you know which days could hit 80 coming up just after the break.
In Sussex County, Beach Mobile Home and RV Supply has the parts you need.
Powered by over 30,000 square feet of inventory at Brass Sales and an amazingly knowledgeable staff, we offer plumbing, electrical, windows, doors, tubs, showers, and even roofing and skirting for your manufactured home. Plus an extensive selection of parts and supplies for your RV, no matter the class, size, or style. Beach Mobile Home and RV Supply in Long Neck, Delaware, your home improvement superstore for all your manufactured housing and RV needs.
This Wednesday at 8 p.m., the Governor's Challenge Selection Show is on the Delmarva Sports Network. A deep dive into five brackets, over 100 teams.
Chris McKelvin.
5 days of the best high school basketball talent all coming to the Eastern Shore.
The freshman delivering and he'll go to the line.
This Wednesday, the only place for the 2023 Governor's Challenge Selection Show is on the Delmarva Sports Network.
Nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again.
Delmarva's Classic Rock, Big 107.7. NBC Nightly News, weeknights at 6:30 on Coast TV.
From gentle ocean breezes to small country towns, Sussex County has it all. That's why you need a real estate company that is familiar with it all. Mann & Sons offers decades of experience throughout Sussex County. Whether it's helping you purchase your forever home or find the perfect vacation rental at the beach, trust our experience. Trust Mann & Sons.
For over 30 years, the difference is clear. Mann & Sons Real Estate.
This weather's brought to you by
Well, what an absolutely gorgeous evening we're seeing across Delmarva, and it's only going to get better from here, especially if you like some warmer weather, because we're going to be seeing our temps rise throughout the upcoming week. Right now, let's take a live look out on our Gateway Subaru camera at the Commander Hotel in Ocean City. There is not a cloud in sight. We've got crystal clear blue skies out there this evening, gorgeous conditions in Ocean City. Temps a little bit cool, though, down to 59 degrees already, so you may want a light jacket if you're walking along the boardwalk this evening in Ocean City, or a really along any of our beach towns, which are our coolest locations right now this evening. 62 in Rehoboth Beach, is 64 in Bethany Beach. A bit warmer inland, where many of us are still right near 70 degrees right now. It's 69 in Selbyville currently. It's 69 in Millsboro, 65 in Milton, 67 degrees in Georgetown. The winds rather light, but they are coming out of the south. That southerly wind direction is important because it's starting to pull in some of that warmer air. So we're not going to see temps nearly as cold as what they have been the last few days, especially not nearly as cold as what we were this morning. This morning we saw temps fall down into the mid-30s across Delmarva. It's probably going to be another week, maybe 10 days before we see those temps get that cold again. Satellite radar picture, not showing a whole lot going on. We've got clear skies across the area. Big blue H right over southeastern Virginia. That means a sprawling area of high pressure controlling our weather here in the Mid-Atlantic. And that is going to be the case for the next several days. So really, it's going to be pretty boring weather for meteorologists, because we're not going to be seeing anything but sunshine. which is great weather for everybody else. Everybody's going to enjoy the weather the next few days. Clear skies overnight tonight. Temps falling into the upper 40s to low 50s by Wednesday morning. Wednesday afternoon, take a look at that. Mid-70s across the area. It's 76 in Rehoboth Beach, 75 in Selbyville, 76 in Georgetown. It gets even warmer Thursday. Thursday morning, we're starting out in the mid-50s, and we're going to be climbing into the upper 70s as we head towards Thursday afternoon. And then take a look at this. Our average high this time of year, 66 degrees. Each of the next 5 days going to be above that, and each of the next 5 days are going to see those temps starting to rise up to 80 degrees by Saturday and Sunday. So if you are heading to the Sea Witch Parade in Rehoboth Beach on Saturday, you're looking at some absolutely gorgeous weather. Maybe a little bit too warm for some people, especially if you got one of those thicker costumes on walking around Rehoboth Beach, as temps going to be climbing up to 74 degrees by parade time. We're going to be looking at sunshine, light winds. It is going to be absolutely gorgeous weather for the parade and really for the festivities all weekend long in Rehoboth Beach. Take a look at this. Our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 7-day forecast. We're talking about sunshine taking over through next Monday. Highs in the 70s and 80s each and every day. It's not until Halloween that those temps fall back down into the 50s.
We want to let our viewers know that for some households that watch Coast TV News with an antenna, today, you may experience losing the over-the-air signal of the broadcast. There are technical changes occurring that may require this temporary outage. A simple rescan for available channels, that'll get Coast TV News back on the television lineup. Wicomico County's Habitat for Humanity is fundraising for its new administrative offices in Fruitland that it purchased in October of last year. So far, it has reached $1.3 million of its $1.8 million fundraising goal. The organization says that the renovation helps it expand its affordable home ownership, critical home repair, and veterans build programs in Wicomico and Somerset counties. The organization expects to operate in that building by April of 2024.
After the break here on Coast TV News at 5, broadband expansion in Delaware. How many households the state says it's connected to internet with the help of a certain implemented plan?
But first, Harrington wants to celebrate Halloween after Halloween. The foods that you can grub on at its upcoming Truck and Treat event. Stay tuned on Coast TV News at 5.
It's truck season here at First State Chevrolet in Georgetown, located on Route 113, just 1 mile north of the DMV.
Get interest rates as low as 0%, no payment for 90 days on this 2023 Chevy Silverado.
Save up to $6,500 on this 22 Silverado dump body.
Plus, we have a huge selection of Chevy certified vehicles.
Stop in or find us on the web at firststatechevy.com.
We're First State Chevy in Georgetown, where we put you, the customer, first. Find new roads.
100.9% classic country plays real country.
Read the file, find something, anything.
You're tense. It's a missing child, isn't it?
I need you to search for trafficking chatter.
Traffic? Are you serious?
Get me out!
Found. Tonight on NBC and streaming on Peacock.
You're doing a great job filling in for Higgy.
It's the worst that could happen.
Oh, boy.
Tell me you're not live tweeting our death.
Magnum PI, Wednesday on NBC and streaming on Peacock.
Doctors, lawyers, teachers, bus drivers, cashiers, librarians, the helpful smile of a helper, a caretaker, a healer, a giver can also hide the deepest suffering. Domestic violence impacts everyone, even our everyday heroes. What is your voices here to help? Call our helpline at 302-467-3310 or visit whatisyourvoice.org.
Nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again.
Delmarva's Classic Rock, Big 107.7.
Visitar a tu médico es el primer paso para mantenerte saludable y prevenir enfermedades.
Su médico conoce su historial médico y puede brindarles las atenciones personalizadas para ustedes.
Los chequeos regulares ayudan a detectar los problemas de salud a tiempo y evitar a que se agraven.
No espere hasta que esté enfermo para ver a su médico.
Haga de su salud una prioridad. Para obtener ayuda para encontrar un médico de atención primaria, llame hoy mismo a Community Behavioral Health.
Sponsored by Ancient Art Stone, where countertops are always a work of art.
On Thursday, that's the 26th, Delaware Governor John Carney joining representatives from Comcast, Verizon, and MediaCom to celebrate progress on broadband expansion in the first state. Get this, nearly $1.9 trillion from the American Rescue Plan and allocated by the governor has connected about 6,000 homes, businesses, and organizations to broadband in Delaware. The state says Delaware is on track to become the first state in the nation to be fully connected.
Harrington plans to celebrate the spooky season even after Halloween. On November 4th, from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., you can check out their Truck or Treat event. The Department of Parks and Recreation says El Primo Taquerias and Bub's Grubs will be on site for some good eats. Of course, there will be candy, too. It is time to take another look at our Coast TV poll. Now we want to know, what are your thoughts on wind farms? We just had the early version, and now it's kind of moving around. Negative has taken the lead just barely. 51%, 44% are still positive, and just 5% saying they're neutral. You can have a say in this. Go vote on CoastTVNews.com or use the Coast TV mobile app. And we're going to show you updated results on Coast TV News at 6.
Coming up, a wicked weekend feast coming to Milton. When and what local restaurants exactly, what they're serving at those local restaurants, we'll tell you next on Coast TV News at 5.
The 2024 Subaru Outback. Go where love takes you. With the legendary capability of the Outback, you'll never run out of new places to explore. Every Outback is made to last, so you can rely on it no matter where your adventures take you. Right now, lease the new 2024 Subaru Outback Onyx Edition for only $299 a month. Or take advantage of financing rates as low as 4.9%. Gateway Subaru is committed to providing the best car buying experience on the shore. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Gateway Subaru. Higher standards. It's always a good time to protect and improve your home's value. At Pinnacle Concrete Coatings, our highly trained experts are dedicated to creating beautiful, durable floors at a fair, honest price. And most jobs are completed in just one day. Our multi-step process uses heavy-duty, high-precision equipment to create gorgeous floors that stand the test of time. 4 times stronger than epoxy and resistant to abrasions, chemicals, and UV damage. And all residential applications are backed by a lifetime warranty. Call to schedule your free estimate. Pinnacle Concrete Coatings, because quality matters.
Welcome to Paris, home of French bread, wine, and now the Olympics. And that's how we kick off the games.
So it's a blimp that looks like bread?
No, it's real bread. It's a baguette, actually.
And how does it fly?
Let me see here. Nope.
Classic Rock, Big 107.7. Never miss a game for your favorite local team. Take the DSN app with you wherever you go. Whether you're out to eat, camping with friends, or at home relaxing with your family, the DSN app notifies you when your team is on live so you can watch the game as it happens or watch videos on demand. Keep up with local sports all from one app. From your mobile device to Fire Stick, Roku, and Apple TV, download the DSN app today. Driven by Preston Automotive Group.
Coming up new on Coast TV News at 6, pedestrian safety in Fenwick Island. What the town is doing to protect those who walk the streets there.
Milton is getting spooky this Saturday. The town is hosting a wicked weekend feast. You can get food from Fat Vinny's, Fractured Prune, and Grandpa Mac. That's from the 28th, 5 to 8, and you don't have to register, just show up to the park.
Well, we've got some gorgeous weather taking over across Delmarva really for the next about a week here along the coast. Right now, to take a live look out on a Hershey Exteriors camera at the 45th Street Tap House, clear skies, temp sitting right around 59 degrees in Ocean City. It is a little cool this evening, but today's really the last cool day before we really start to see those temps rise. This evening, though, we are going to fall down into the mid-50s, but we can see on our Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling 10-day forecast, we're going to be climbing upper 70s, low 80s by the weekend. Next week, though, much chillier air returns.
Alex, thank you, and thanks for joining us here for Coast TV News at 5.
For more news, more local weather, download that Coast TV News app.
Inside Edition's up next.
And, of course, we're going to see you later tonight for Coast TV News at 6. Have a great evening.